You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Thursday, January 30th, 2020. This week, we have been talking about confirmation, one of the great sacraments that we have as Catholics. We've already talked about how confirmation is basically a personal Pentecost when we say yes to the Spirit, yes to the Church, and the bishop calls down the Holy Spirit to be within us. We've talked about the various things that happen during the sacrament of confirmation. And yesterday we started looking at the five baptismal promises that we stand and declare as an adult when we are confirmed. We've talked about the first one, renouncing Satan, all of his works and empty promises. The second one, that we believe in God and that he is our Father. The third one, that we believe in Jesus Christ and that he is our Lord. And today we're going to talk about the last two. Now, the fourth thing that you will stand and publicly declare as a belief and as something that directs your life when you are confirmed is your belief in the third person in the Trinity, the Holy Spirit. In case you haven't noticed, the Holy Spirit plays a pretty big role in confirmation. The Holy Spirit, of course, is the third part of God and part of every sacrament. But the sacrament of confirmation is when those specific gifts of the Holy Spirit are called down to dwell within us. Now, what does it mean when we say that we believe in the Holy Spirit? Well, first of all, it means that we believe there is one God, but that God has three parts, the Trinity, the mystery of the Trinity. But also remember, the Holy Spirit, and this is a little bit confusing, but stay with me. The Holy Spirit is the love that exists between the Father and the Son. Now, God is infinite. The way he loves is infinite. So the love between the Father and the Son is so big, so immense, so endless, so huge that it actually formed a third person. The love of God is so powerful that it created the third person of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit. It is this love that is the Holy Spirit. So what does it mean to say, I believe in the Holy Spirit? Well, it means that I can see what I am called to do, that my life, my mission of my life is an adventure in growing in love. Just as the Father and the Son love each other infinitely, so I am called to enter into this mystery of love, to love my brothers and sisters and my friends and my classmates and my parents and everyone with the true love of God. When the Holy Spirit is called down to dwell within us when we are confirmed, it is this love that enters us. And we are called to give that love, to spread it around. That is what it means to say that we believe in the Holy Spirit. Now, the fifth baptismal promise that we renew has to do with the larger church, believing in the church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, all of these traditions that we have as Catholics. We are saying that we believe in this. Now, what does this mean? Well, in order to understand this, we need to understand what truly happens when we are confirmed. Just like baptism, you can only be confirmed once. And once you are confirmed, it is not something that you can undo. Sometimes we think that we should just maybe volunteer for something at church. And if it doesn't work out, well, maybe we shouldn't have volunteered, or maybe we could even go find a different parish. We might think that. But that is not the case. And that is not what we are called to do when we are confirmed. Now, the actual Latin words that confirmation comes from are the same words that people use when they talk about the branding of cattle. Now, have you ever heard about branding cattle? In places where they have big open pastures, a farmer will take a piece of metal that is in a certain shape or a letter, get that metal very, very hot, and then press it to the hide of a cow. That way, if certain farmers' cows are mixed up, they can tell who owns which ones. Now, this is what happens to our souls when we are confirmed. There is a permanent mark placed on our soul. And just as you can't rub off a branding mark that a farmer puts on his cow, you cannot remove the brand that is placed on us when we are confirmed. We aren't volunteering for something that we can do as long as it's fun. We are becoming permanent members of the organism of our church. Just as St. Paul says that we are the body of Christ, so too when we are confirmed, we become part of Jesus's church. Imagine your own body. Imagine if your hand suddenly rebelled and didn't want to be part of you anymore. Your whole body would be affected. You wouldn't be the same. You wouldn't be able to live and interact with the world in the same way. It's true when you are a confirmed member too. If you later in life decide that you don't want to be Catholic anymore or practice your faith, the entire church will be affected because as a confirmed member, you are part of the organism, the living church. Now, I tell you all of this simply because being confirmed in your faith is a big step. You are publicly saying to the church, but even more importantly, to God, that you believe and that you are ready to do God's work. Now, with all of this, my challenge for you today is to simply revisit these final two promises, that you believe in the Holy Spirit, which is the love that exists between the Father and the Son, and that you believe in the Holy Church, His Catholic Holy Church. Do you really believe those things? When it's time for you to be confirmed, will you stand up and publicly declare that you believe those things? That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be. A quick reminder that if you are a patron, to please head over to the Patreon site and grab all of your wonderful goodies. If you are not a patron, I invite you to consider joining us. We have lots of goodies every single week, and it is my joy to think of ways for you to go a little bit deeper with the content shared here. To join us on Patreon, simply find the link in the notes for this podcast episode.